At the climax of the Bahrain Grand Prix, in doing battle with Hamilton, Verstappen overtook around the outside, momentarily leaving the track completely at the exit of Turn 4. This was considered an illegal move, and he handed the position back to Hamilton, after which he was unable to re-overtake. The understanding of what was and what wasn't allowed was muddied by the fact that Lewis had been running wide at that corner for over half the race, a fact that Verstappen was surprised to learn about over the radio when his engineer told him to do the same to minimise time loss to the Mercedes. Following the Red Bull discussion, race control told Hamilton to stop running wide at Turn 4. This was something Hamilton was surprised to hear, as his understanding was that cars could run wide there without consequence. And the previous day in qualifying, that corner had been a focus of the stewards, as they were stripping the times of any driver who ran off track there in setting a lap. So, what was allowed, what wasn't, and why do we have such inconsistent and confusing rule sets about this still? Some of these questions I will answer next. First, let me thank NordVPN for sponsoring this video and helping keep the channel running. NordVPN has 5,500 servers across 60 countries that allow you to use the internet anonymously and internationally. They allow you to make 6 simultaneous connections under one account, so you can protect your data while logging on at the beach with your phone, tablet, and laptop simultaneously and still let your sunburned partner browse safely on one of your 3 spare connections. NordVPN has double data encryption, no data logging, and cyber sec security to help you feel secure. NordVPN are offering Chainbear viewers a 2-year plan plus 1 additional month with a huge discount when you visit nordvpn.com/chainbear and use code chainbear at checkout. So go to nordvpn.com/chainbear. Now back to the video. Up front, I'm going to say I do think Lewis Hamilton's win was deserved and hard fought for. I think Max was right to give the position back for his off-track overtake, and I'm glad he did that rather than drive on and let post-race penalties sort it out. Knowing the result of the checkered flag is high up the list of things we want. It's also clear that Max was the fastest racer of the day, and he should and could have won. I was rooting for him to pull it off. But there's plenty more fights left to come, but this race must have felt like the result that slipped through his fingers. What a battle of strategy and racecraft it was at that point. So let me build up to these opinions then, and I'm sure I can maybe probably justify them. The real problem here is not with Max or Lewis, but the rules, and to a certain degree, the stewarding. It's annoying. Let's start with how the rules work. The main overarching rules for going racing in Formula 1 are the sporting regulations, one of 3 volumes laying out the regulatory framework for the sport, underneath the more general international sporting code. Article 27 of the sporting regulations details driving, with section 27.3 saying, "Drivers must make every reasonable effort to use the track at all times and may not deliberately leave the track without a justifiable reason. Drivers will be judged to have left the track if no part of the car remains in contact with it, and for the avoidance of doubt, any white lines defining the track edges are considered to be part of the track, but the curbs are not. Should a car leave the track, the driver may rejoin. However, this must be done when it is safe to do so and without gaining any lasting advantage. At the absolute discretion of the race director, a driver may be given the opportunity to give back the whole of any advantage he gained by leaving the track." Now we'll come back to this in a bit, but this defines the track as the area between the white lines, including the white line itself, and if a car is considered within the track limits, it must have any part of it still touching the line. So, basically, a sliver of tyre on the white line is good enough for it to still be in. Fine. This isn't the be-all and end-all, though. When the teams turn up to an event, the race director issues custom event notes for the track and weekend program. This includes a detailed map of the circuit with official corner numbers, marshal posts, sectors and so on, as well as pit lane geography, tyre notes from Pirelli, and rules and guidance particular to the event. The guidance might include where you can and cannot make practice starts, how to evacuate cars from the grid through the gates and the pit wall, and any changes made to the circuit since the last meeting. The Bahrain event notes included a special article saying track limits at Turn 4 would not be monitored with respect to lap times, and specifically defines the limits of the track there as the artificial grass and gravel trap. Otherwise, see Article 27.3 of the sporting regs as usual. What this means is running wide at Turn 4 would incur no penalty or lap time deletions in any session. However, at 5 p.m. on Friday, a revision to the event's notes was published changing the track limit rules at Turn 4. Instead, practice sessions, which in FIA speak includes qualifying, is technically labelled qualifying practice, any car that runs wider than the outside curbs would have that time deleted. So the track limits were a little bit wider than the white lines, but mostly strict and important to respect if you wanted to set a quick lap. For the race, however, stewards would revert back to ignoring the limits on the exit of Turn 4 and let drivers go as far as the natural edge, the grass and gravel. So all drivers should have been well aware they could play fast and loose with the edge of Turn 4, and most of them did indeed run consistently wide there during the race. It is the fastest, least resistant path through the corner, and it gives you the greatest exit speed. It's inherently advantageous to run outside of the lines there. So Verstappen was mistaken in being surprised when hearing Hamilton was running wide there. He could have grabbed a bunch of extra time by doing so himself more regularly. And when it comes to passing on track, well, that's much simpler. Let's go back to Article 27.3 of the Sporting Regs. Should a car leave the track, the driver may rejoin. However, this may only be done when it is safe to do so and without gaining any lasting advantage. In this clause, a lasting advantage is kept deliberately vague to swallow up all manner of possibilities, but essentially it is used to enforce two major actions: overtaking off track and defending off track. And by defending, I mean, did you stop yourself being overtaken by running off track? Something that mostly takes place through chicanes. Naturally, as Max was all four wheels off track as he passed Hamilton, race control asked him to give the position back, as detailed in the back end of the same article. What is weird and annoying is, well, it's a couple of things. Why did race control tell Hamilton to stop running wide at Turn 4 if they'd specifically detailed the limits in the event notes? According to that, Hamilton's line was fine, and they let him do it 29 times up to that point, only stepping in after Red Bull started having a conversation with Verstappen about it. Is it because Hamilton was running too wide? He was often much wider through Turn 4 than other drivers, but still within the letter of the article in the event notes, so you can't really blame him for taking the mick. Is it because of their slightly nebulous lasting advantage wording? If you run wide for half the race, do the stewards start thinking, well, this is adding up to a lasting advantage if we're honest here? And this is what Michael Massey seemed to suggest in his post-race interviews. He said the rules did stay consistent through the race and that every car, bar one, was doing the right thing within what was expected. Every car, bar one. He also stated that even though track limits would not be monitored in the race regarding lap times, they would still be monitored with regards to gaining a lasting advantage, which definitely includes overtaking and may well involve consistently running so wide you're gobbling up tenths of seconds. Put together, this suggests they may well have told Hamilton to rein it in because he was, well, taking the mickey. And okay, fine, but you can understand both Hamilton's frustration in following the rules as he understood them and the audience's frustration for rules that appear unreasonably woolly. And you know what would solve this? It's not a new solution. Just use the white line as the track limit. It's easy to police. It's easy for everyone to see if the car is out of bounds, if you're a steward, a driver, or a TV viewer. You don't have to have an argument about interpretations of the wording. It's a simple, observable in or out regulation. The drivers will sometimes complain about this, but who cares, honestly? Stay inside the lines. Delete out-of-bounds laps in qualifying and give them a 3 strikes, then 5 seconds in the race. Add a bollard if drivers find some of the edges hard to see. You can't always put grass or gravel on the apron for various design reasons, but you can enforce track limit breaches with well-placed sensors that they're already using. It's time to simplify things. Stay inside the white lines, and let's go racing.